Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week we're getting a halibut fishing lesson out of Ilwaco, Washington, plus some bonus salmon fishing off of Long Beach. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television. It's early summer and halibut season off the Washington coast is open and the salmon are starting to show. This morning we're getting a late start out of Ilwaco for a good reason.
The late start today is because we had a -2.2 tide, which the Astoria Bar, Cape Disappointment, it can be really rough. So we're just being cautious, that's all. We are gonna go out about 16 miles from the tips and hit some halibut. We got a couple little spots. And then after we got our halibut, we're gonna run a little bit north up Long Beach and grab some Chinook. It's gonna be a good day. The ocean's gonna be flat. It's gonna be beautiful. Well, we just ran out. It was about a 45 minute run. We're 16 miles from the Jaws. We are at the edge of the Astoria Canyon, which we're in 500 feet of water. That way, a quarter of a mile, it's about 1,000 feet. And so all the welling comes up, which brings the feed up for the halibut. Today we're using the Tanicum 750s and 1100 reels. Got these from England Marine. And two of these were running off of batteries. The other two were gonna run off of boat power, and make sure that's down there so I don't lose that. These electric reels are the coolest thing ever. If you've ever reeled 4 pounds of lead up from 500 feet of water, it's a workout. But now it's easy. Okay, today we have a smorgasbord of bait. We'll see what they want to hit on. Trying some new stuff today. We've got a little bit of skipjack from a trip to Mexico. We'll give that a shot. The herring's been real good. We've got mackerel out of the bellies of the halibut from earlier this year. They had mackerel in them, so we got some mackerel. And these white grubs have been very successful, especially if you just put a little piece of skin on them and we'll see what they want. We're gonna run 4 rods because we're fishing so deep, we're only gonna run 4. These herring that we're using, we actually jigged them ourselves down in Newport. That was a kick in the pants, how we rigged the herring. One hook. And a lot of people use stretchy string. This is a lot quicker and a lot tougher. Just a couple zip ties. We're gonna put a little bit of skipjack on this one, and then never goes down without a bit of butt juice. Okay, that's one bait ready. Well, these are Pacific sories. They look like a needlefish. They're actually pretty prevalent here. And a lot of the commercial guys use the sories because it's a bait that is here in the Pacific Ocean. These fish feed on them all the time. We've had days out here that the sories did really well. We had days out here the halibut did really well. The reason I kind of have one, it'll release the scent more. Two, it's so long and we've only got one hook. I want them to focus in on where the hook is. And then we are gonna take and add a little squid to the sori. Just a little chunk of squid. This stays on really well. And then again, butt juice.
You know, I've fished from Alaska all the way down to California. This is the first time I've been out in the ocean fishing for halibut. I can't believe it. I can't wait to see how today. Yeah, this is going to be so awesome. Thank you so much, Scott, for letting me out here.
Hey, new experience is what it's all about.
Welcome back to a flat, calm ocean outside of Ilwaco, Washington. I'm Justin Wolf. With any luck, halibut is on the menu tonight.
Where we're at right here, we haven't got any monsters, but they're eaters. They're the ones we've been keeping have been about 20 pounds. Some a little bigger, some a little smaller. We'll just see what shows up today. There's been a 40-pounder caught a quarter mile from us here. Friend of mine, so there's bigger fish here, but usually we're just kind of in a hurry to get a couple of eaters and then go like today, get a couple of eaters and go salmon fishing. We are putting on 4 pounds of lead because we want to drift really slow. We need to stay right on top of the fish. Point of the spreader bar, my main reason for using a spreader bar is to keep the bait off the main line as it goes down. Because if your bait is here, it can get all twisted up and it's a mess. This keeps it away. I'm sure there's other reasons, but that is the main reason I use a spreader bar. So there's your spreader bar, there's your 4 pound weight, and we got a piece of mackerel here. We're gonna see how that goes. Okay. We want the bead just below the waterline, and then you hit reset, which will put it at a zero. It zeroes it out. Mm-hmm. So when you drop it down, it'll read your depth. But the main thing, when it comes up, it's going to stop at like 12 feet. So that way we don't end up with the bead coming into the rod, and then you can actually turn it off, and it'll come up. It'll come up another 6 feet, and after 6 feet, you have to reel.
Gotcha.
Okay. But to let him down, it's real easy. Just the regular drag, and you just drop him down. And then to stop it, it's just like a regular reel to bring it up. Oh, we got a fabulous drift today. I'm not gonna have to run the boat hardly at all. We're a half mile an hour. That stoplight is where we wanna fish. We've drifted drifting east. So we're gonna go back and get on the other side of that stoplight. And then we're gonna drift right over it. And when we hit that stoplight, we should be on the fish. They're right next to the canyon, which upwells a lot of nutrients. And so there's a lot of bait for these fish. Okay, guys, let's drop them down.
So what's our depth here?
Our depth here is 499.
470. Still going. 500. 530. Boom. 550 feet.
Got to reel in your first one, Chris.
Yeah.
You can't use the electric reel on your first one. Sorry, buddy. So can't crank.
Stay off the bottom. Yeah. Right off the bottom. So we're not using circle hooks, so we get to hook these guys. And so what they're going to do is they're going to take it, and you go bang, 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 bang. And when they really start pulling on it, you just grab the throttle, basically. Just full throttle it, and that should pull it right in and hook them. Or you can hold it and set it.
Since it's your first one, you hand crank it.
Yeah.
You gotta hand crank it.
Yeah. I'll pull the fuse on his.
Yeah. That's looking good, Jack. That's looking good, buddy. All right. He's there, buddy.
Thank.
Let him. Put some big tugs on it.
Chris got up.
Chris hooked up.
Wait a minute, buddy. Right here. Yeah, yeah, there you go. No, no, you gotta fight this thing.
We're at 520. I'm gaining a foot of crank.
Also, you can adjust how fast it reels.
There you go, he's on.
It's a double.
Just keep on bringing it up.
Yeah, I think mine came off.
Well, let's drop it down since we're right on top.
No, he didn't.
He's still there.
He's still there.
Yeah.
Little guy.
Yeah, probably a little.
When you're reeling up.
When you're reeling up, I mean, what? You want to go full throttle?
You can run it full throttle on these smaller ones. What's really cool about these reels, and I've talked to the factory, is they have a drag. So you can run it full throttle. You can run it full throttle and see the drag working here, how it stops. That's just like you cranking as fast as you can, and the drag is doing the work. So you can run them full throttle. You're not going to hurt anything.
That's your first halibut ever.
We're on the edge of the Astoria Canyon, where we're starting off with a double hookup on halibut, and a first for Chris Turvey.
It is. A halibut.
Keeper, what do we got?
Pulling up. There you go. That's a nice fish. This is a great eater.
It's just a perfect size.
Yeah, it really is.
Oh, that's a little guy.
Is that a small one over there?
Do we keep those? That size?
Oh, you Kempin? Keep. You keep any size. It's do you want to keep it?
What do you guys think? It's your call.
We've got. We're in them here. If it's a small one.
It's a small one. What do you want to do, buddy? It's your first.
Let it go. Okay. It's all good. First halibut ever.
Right on, buddy.
That's awesome. Thank you so much.
You bet.
That is a perfect eater. We had sari and squid on this one, and we had herring and squid on the other one. So we're just gonna send down the same baits and see if their big brother likes the meal we're offering. This is where we're fishing. It's our super secret numbers, but this little spot here, anytime the boat is touching that stop sign, it is money. I've been off it by 20 yards and not been able to catch fish. It's just crazy. But halibut are like that. They got their spots they like for whatever reason they want. And if you find them, you want to mark them. And you can see right here, this is right where we're at. There's that big mark is maybe a halibut off the ground, but there's bait down around them. There's a lot of action going on right there. That's a nice fish.
This is a big one.
There you go, buddy.
There we go.
460.
7-6. Five. Up.
Oh, and it ran into his rod.
Yeah, I just turned it off.
Yep. Oh yeah, it's a nice keeper. All right, Scott, me a flip. Broke nice fish.
Big fish.
Okay. All right.
Okay, let me see if I can get out of here.
Oh yeah, buddy.
There's a fish.
Yes.
Yeah.
That boy.
Who is nice. on the grub?
Sure he does it.
Yeah. Oh yeah. The grub.
On that white grub. What'd you have on the tip? A little white meat halibut?
A little white skin.
A white skin did it.
It's the other white meat.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. That's.
We're going to need some players.
Thank you. Yeah.
Wow.
There you go. He's on.
Tough fight. I mean, it's tired. Just exhausted. the gap, buddy?
Yeah, the best.
All right.
I like it.
Oh, yeah. That's a keeper. Oh, yeah. Ready?
There you go. White grub. That's a nice chicken.
It's a nice chicken. It's a good eater right there.
Yeah.
It's not quite as big as Turvey's, but hey.
Yeah. I use that here, the white grub, with a little piece of white halibut skin. And that trick was told to me by a very good friend of mine who actually just stopped by and said hi on his way to go get salmon. And it's done the trick. Really, it really has done the trick.
Welcome back to our secret halibut hole on the edge of the Astoria Canyon. I'm Justin Wolf. We just need one more halibut on board to complete our limit, and then we control super baits for salmon. But first, here's a great way to rig super baits specifically for saltwater salmon fishing.
So we finished up halibut fishing, and now we're gonna go in and try to catch some salmon. What we're gonna tie up here is probably one of my favorite rigs for ocean coho and kings. It's a single hook rig. And the reason why I like it, especially with some of the big coho runs we get, you can, with a single hook, it's a lot safer and you can release the fish a lot easier. And the way we're gonna do that is by putting a big 5-aught hook, a bobber stop, it's just a real simple setup. Hook, bobber stop, need to grab a bead. A lot of guys will just do the bobber stop and one bead. I feel like you need a couple beads, and the reason being is that I feel like it just takes a little bit of the tension off of the when it's spinning.
There we go. Fish on.
So what we got is 5-aught, bobber stop, couple beads. Yeah. We're gonna take our line, we're gonna feed it through the super bait. The cool thing about that bobber stop is now you can adjust the length of that hook. That's just a little bit farther back than what I like. So we're gonna slide it down just a little bit. Pull that. You like that hook right about there. That's a really good setup for ocean fishing, mainly because, you know, wild fish and whatnot that you're releasing, it's easier to manage one hook versus multiple hooks.
Here, why don't you step over just a little bit. There he is. Another eater.
Huh? More dinner. Look at that mouth.
Yeah, so we're gonna run the standard cup plugs, and then we're gonna run the original super bait, the original skinnies.
Well, we just ran from the halibut grounds to Long Beach. We're about in the middle of the Long Beach Peninsula. We're in 45 feet of water. We were gonna head to 32 feet, but we had salmon jumping all around us. So we thought we would get in. Ooh, here's bait right here. So we got bait here. And it's scattered. And so since it's scattered, that means there's fish crashing through there. So we're gonna see what happens.
Tuna that we're putting in here, and just plain tuna in oil out of a can. And then we're gonna put a little salmon slammer or garlic bloody tuna on there. What do you got there, buddy?
Salmon slammer. And just kinda
fill those holes a little bit, just a little extra gel, just a little extra juice, a little scent to get out there. And as this bait turns around, it's going to leave a scent trail, and that's what we're looking for.
This particular flasher is a new flasher from Brad's, and it's going to be released here in a few months or late summer. And the way it works is you snap onto the front of it. When a fish strikes, it detaches. Now it's breakaway. But it's further than that. There's also some elasticity, and it helps keep the fish on there. There's 18 inches of stretch with that bungee. Super simple to rig. You hook it up there and plug it in the back, and now you're fishing. When a fish strikes, it detaches. The other cool feature about this flasher is it also is adjustable. So there's fast, medium, and slow. And the way you adjust that is by just unsnapping the front, going through a different hole, reattaching your bumper. Now it's fishing a completely different speed. But what's really cool about it is you can mix and match different size baits. Like let's say you have a big bait on this side of the boat and a small bait on that side of the boat. One or the other is going to be fishing better than the other. The cool thing about this flasher is now you can adjust it. If one's not thumping well enough, you can make it thump harder. If one's thumping too fast, you can slow it down. So that's a cool feature with this new Brad's 360 Evolution flasher that's coming out.
There you go, I got a king on.
Get it, Scott. Get it.
Double. Got a little feeder's nut. We're going to let that one go. Don't add it. Unhook it.
Yeah, they got to be 22 inches or bigger in order to keep them, and that one I can tell you right now is probably 19.
There you go, buddy. Yeah, we're gonna have to measure.
It's legal by an inch, so it's going home, hitting the frying pan.
I hope you enjoyed today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, there would be no show. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.